Hi guys, it's Weed It, and I have been spending some time turning DVDs and CDs into canvases. And of course, the hole is always an issue, so I've been working with different ways to take out the hole to smooth the texture, and I have found a way that gives me a really nice round canvas. Now this is still drying just a little bit, but this is completely smooth. You can't tell that there used to be a hole there when I run my finger over it. And the same thing with this one, and this one, and even this one where I filled the hole and I put too much filler in. I still managed to get a smooth canvas. This one is still really drying. So I want to go through and show you what I discovered. If you look at a CD or a DVD, one side has got what I call it's a ridge, and I'm running my fingernail along it. And I think I've been playing with and trying to make canvases. These were some of my first attempts, and that's where I started realizing, okay, in this one I got the hole filled in, but you can see there's a ridge, and I didn't want that. This one, I got the hole too full, and I thought I had a DVD that shows it's right here. This is actually the back of a pour that I did. Here you can see that ridge really well, and you don't want to use that side of the DVD or the CD. And another thing, you want to be careful, because if you don't prep it, that's my gesso, and I can just scrape it off with my thumbnail. So we want to keep in mind those two things. So when you get your CD or your DVD, make sure that ridge side is down. We're not going to work with it. You want the other side, and we're going to end up gessoing this and working on this side. But to start off with, I want to go ahead and abrade the surface. So this is just a nail block for acrylic nails, and you know, you're not trying to get everything off. You just want to scratch up that surface to give the gesso something to cling to. So, take a minute. And of course, the more you rub, the better it will stick. That's just a given, but you don't really have to do much. And if anybody is stressing, I need to explain, the CDs and DVDs that I use, the bad man and my father were both computer geeks, and I can say that as a math nerd. So I have an abundance of odd, weird CDs and DVDs floating around, and I wanted to use them. Now, the next thing we're going to do, and I don't know why I put my paper out, because I don't want my paper, we're going to fill the hole. And this is what I have found. I'm working on this is a Heidi Swap Make Pretty Stuff mat, but it's just a silicone mat. So any kind of mat that you use hot glue with, and I think parchment paper, if I'm not mistaken, will also work very well. And I'm sorry, it's trying to focus. Let me give it something to focus on there. And that ceiling fan is flickering. I've just got a new setup, which is one, why you hear so much traffic, and two, I don't have the lighting quite worked out, but I'm working on that. So with your hot glue gun, and I'm using just a cheapy hot glue gun with the small, it's a mini hot glue gun, put about 1.5 squeezes. I'm pushing my CD down, I'm holding it, there's one and a little bit. It's really not even a half. And fold whatever you've got over on top and just kind of rub it and act like you're burnishing it in. And again, you're doing this on the side that does not have that ridge. Now it's got a little valley, and this is where I was playing, and see, this is where I just gessoed it. I just filled it and gessoed it. I've got to let this cool a little bit before I can pull it off. But here, I didn't fill in the indention that goes along. So when I was working with watercolors, of course, they bled into that circle. So that wasn't any good. And this isn't what I wanted anyway. I was playing and experimenting. I put watercolor ground on here, and I didn't like that. So I found out a way to do it, and this is another one, again, not one that turned out well. As far as the painting goes, I was still experimenting, but it's completely smooth and you can't see the hole, and it makes a perfect round canvas. Same thing on this one. Everything is filled in very nicely and there's no indention. It's completely smooth. It makes really good canvases. Now those were all, quote, fails when I was experimenting, but I don't mind. It cost me a little bit of watercolor. And that's it. Okay, let me see if this is cool enough. Yep. All right. So now that I've done that, I don't know if you can see, it's just about perfect. Okay, it does go over a little bit right here, and that could be a problem if we weren't going to follow up. So anyway, this is what I've got on both sides. It's filled in nicely. This has got that ridge on it. This is the abraded side. There's just enough with like one and a little bit to completely fill that hole. I'm going to gesso it. And that's not going to, if I was really worried about making sure this adhered, then I would probably wipe it off with alcohol. But that's not my concern right now. I'm not doing anything that fantastic with these. And you'll be able to see when you put the gesso on that it's not smooth in the center. It's not going to be nice enough for a good canvas. Okay, so now I've got to let that dry. And I'm trying to get my sponge into the water. I don't use brushes anymore with gesso because the brushes tend to they get ruined so quickly, and really and truly I have started looking for alternatives to, quote, art supplies. Okay, so once you've got it gessoed, and I'm going to set this one aside and pull, say, this one out, which isn't good. It's gessoed, I've got it glued, okay. I wonder why I have this green. I have no idea. Anyway, so it's gessoed. The center is filled. I overfilled it, and there's a bit of a rough spot right there with the hot glue as well. I'm trying to get the camera to pick that up. There we go. So I need to handle that, and I need to handle this rigid area. So, all-purpose joint compound. I keep this in the studio because it comes in so handy. I like to use it instead of, say, plaster and put it on hardboard and stuff. And this is already mixed up. So just take some with, I'm using a tongue depressor, but a popsicle stick, anything, a credit card is fine, and smear that over the area that you need to smooth out, okay? And once you've done that, then I just come back and sort of scrape until I feel like I've gotten all the rough areas more or less smoothed over. Now I've got quite an issue with that hot glue right there. So I put a fair bit on in that area. Okay, so there I have my joint compound on there, and I've got to let that dry. So And let me cover my joint compound up before it dries out. You can also tint joint compound with acrylic paint or, you know, powder tint, powder pigment, and apply it to a substrate. All right, once I've done that, and I'll use this one because this one was pretty bad. All you do is let this dry and then come back with that same nail file, nail buff thing that you abraded the surface with, and go over and buff it until it's smooth. And that's all it takes, guys. This gets you as many wonderful round substrates that you want for virtually nothing. And I hate paying for substrates. I just, you know, if I can find a way to make one, then I'm going to go that route. I wanted to do a little trio of watercolors for my classroom, and I'm going to get two of them. I've set them aside. And they're not, I mean, they're very simple, and they're going to be like on a ribbon or a piece of lace or something, and I'll hang them in the classroom. There's another one that goes with it that I've still got to do to finish this up. But I just wanted something simple, but I didn't want to spend a lot of money just making something that I'm going to hang in my classroom. So that's why I started looking into, okay, how can I create nice substrates that I can paint on? And these would be perfect to make snowmen if you just stacked them up. And I think I will probably end up trying that. I have to figure out what I'm going to use for maybe the smallest one. But anyway, this just, it's a perfect way to get nice smooth where you can reuse those CDs or DVDs and you don't have that obvious hole in the middle. In fact, you get it so that there is no sign of the hole. Hope you found this helpful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, hit that like button, and subscribe as I find more ways to save money and improve what we're working with. Thanks, guys. Bye.